Princess Charlotte is gearing up for her first day of school, where she will need to get used to being called a peculiar surname which stems from her royal heritage. Princess Charlotte is starting reception year at the prestigious St. Thomas's Battersea School on Thursday. The exciting day will bring many changes into the life of the four-year-old princess, including being addressed as Charlotte Cambridge by her school friends and teachers. Just like most members of the royal family, Princess Charlotte's surname comes from her parents' title, Duke and Duchess of Cambridge. Similarly to her, Prince George is known in school as George Cambridge. Their father and uncle, respectively Prince William and Prince Harry, were known as William and Harry Wales, a surname passed on by Prince Charles, the Prince of Wales. As explained by the royal family's official website, royals can be known both by the name of the royal house, and by a surname, which are not always the same. The website reads, "Just as children can take their surnames from their father, so sovereigns normally take the name of their house from their father." For this reason, Queen Victoria's eldest son Edward VII belonged to the House of Saxe-Coburg-Gotha, the family name of his father Prince Albert. Edward VII's son George V became the second king of that dynasty when he succeeded to the throne in 1910. In 1917, there was a radical change, when George V specifically adopted Windsor, not only as the name of the house or dynasty but also as the surname of his family. The family name was changed as a result of anti-German feeling during the First World War, and the name Windsor was adopted after the castle of the same name. Princess Charlotte will have special chaperones on her fifth day of school, Kensington Palace has confirmed. Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, Prince William and her brother Prince George will all be with her as she enters the gate of St. Thomas's Battersea School for the first time. And to mark Charlotte's first day of school, Kensington Palace will likely organize a short photo call ahead of the beginning of the lessons, to the delight of royal fans. Kate will be particularly happy to be able to take her daughter to school, as she was forced to miss her eldest son's beginning of reception year last September due to the severe morning sickness she was suffering from while pregnant of Prince Louis. While Princess Charlotte is waiting to meet her new school friends, Prince George is returning to the £6,429 A-term school for his second year. The little Cambridge is said to be very protective of his siblings, and will likely look after Charlotte on her special day. Royal biographer Penny Jr. told Hello! Magazine, "Prince George is a very protective and lovely older brother. I'm sure he'll look after his little sister and take great pride in showing her the ropes." But George is not the only member of the royal family Charlotte will meet on Thursday at her new school, as St. Thomas's Battersea is also attended by 6-year-old Maud Elizabeth Daphne Marina Windsor. Maud is the 50th in line to the throne, daughter of Lord Frederick, son of Prince Michael of Kent, and Sophie Winkleman. And, according to her mother, little Maud is also a close friend of Prince George. She told Hello! Magazine, "We were invited to tea at Kensington Palace just before Princess Charlotte was born. Maud and George got on very well. He is a very clever, articulate little boy and was speaking long before other toddlers his age. Princess Charlotte will spend the next year learning lots of fun and exciting things as she starts her formal education." The little royal joins the reception class at Thomas's Battersea on Thursday, and her parents the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge will be at the school gates to wish her luck. After they wave her off, Charlotte will join her new classmates, sit down at her new desk and get started with the private school's packed curriculum, and it includes some very exciting subjects. The school's website states, "We believe that the early years foundation stage is fundamental in instilling positive dispositions towards learning. In the reception year, children will play and explore, make choices and learn to have a go and persevere, be creative and solve problems, form good relationships, be safe, secure and happy. A stimulating environment, including a multi-sensory outdoor play area, supports the teachers' planned activities and the children's own initiatives for learning. They focus on 7 key areas of learning: personal, social and emotional development, communication and language, physical development, literacy, maths, understanding the world and art and design. We've taken a look at some of the things the young princess will be learning over the next few months. Maths. In her maths lessons, Charlotte will improve her counting and learn how to do basic addition and subtraction. She and her classmates will also learn about shapes, space and measurements. English. In reception, the kids at Thomas's will be taught the link between sounds and letters so they can begin to read and write. Staff use a systematic, synthetic phonics approach to reading. The website states, "Our pupils have a love of books and reading from their earliest days in school." Reading mastery helps children to unlock learning in all areas of school life and beyond. We have an exciting literacy and literature-rich learning environment to ignite children's interest, and their writing is celebrated and displayed. The children engage in a wide range of reading and writing activities during their days in school. We are well-resourced and ICT opportunities are embraced. Our library is used by early years and we have a full-time librarian. Part of her role is to inspire reading and to arrange author presentations at school. Physical education. For pay, Charlotte will get to try a number of new activities and sports. These including gym, games and ballet. They will also be taught about healthy eating choices and why exercise is so important. Languages. Children will have one French lesson a week, which will be a wonderful introduction to the language.